In the world of professional hockey, enforcers are players who specialize in physical play and fighting on the ice. These players are often tasked with protecting their teammates by intimidating or fighting opposing players who engage in dirty play or roughing up their teammates. While the role of enforcers has evolved over the years, they remain a unique and controversial aspect of the sport. Some see them as necessary protectors, while others view them as relics of a bygone era. Nevertheless, the legacy of hockey enforcers lives on in the hearts and minds of fans who admire their toughness, loyalty, and dedication to their teams. Welcome to Smoke and Ice, the show where we take a deep dive into the world of enforcers and explore the legends of the game. In this episode, we'll be focusing on one of the most legendary enforcers in hockey history, Dave "Tiger" Williams. Known for his aggressive playing style and willingness to drop the gloves, Williams became one of the most feared players on the ice during his time in the NHL. Join us as we explore the life and career of Tiger Williams, and the legacy he left behind as one of the greatest enforcers in the history of ice hockey. Make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you can be notified right as our videos release. Stick around to the end of the video to see a compilation of some of Tiger Williams' best fights. Now, Smoke and Ice with Tiger Williams. David James "Tiger" Williams was born on February 3, 1954, in Weyburn, Saskatchewan, Canada. He was a Canadian former professional hockey player, famously known as the NHL's career leader in penalty minutes. Williams began his NHL career in the 1974-75 season with the Toronto Maple Leafs after being drafted by them in the second round, 31st overall, in the 1974 NHL Amateur Draft. He played on five different NHL teams during his career, but he was best known for his role as an enforcer. While in Toronto, Williams broke many Maple Leaf and NHL penalty minute records and led the league in penalty minutes twice with 338 in 1976-77 and 298 in 1978-79. He played with the Maple Leafs until he was traded to the Vancouver Canucks on February 18, 1980, for Rick Babe and Bill Derlego. In Vancouver, Williams played an integral role in the team's surprise run to the Stanley Cup Finals in 1982. During his tenure in Vancouver, he scored a career high of 35 goals and 62 points while amassing a league-leading 343 penalty minutes in 77 games during the 1980-81 season. After Vancouver, Williams played for the Detroit Red Wings and the Los Angeles Kings before being traded to the Hartford Whalers during the 1987-88 NHL season. He officially retired in 1988. Throughout his career, Williams earned many accolades, including playing in the 1981 NHL All-Star Game and the 1982 Stanley Cup Final. Aside from hockey, Williams was also a published author. In 1984, he co-wrote his autobiography, Tiger, A Hockey Story, with James Lawton. He also released a cookbook in 1987 called Done Like Dinner, Tiger in the Kitchen, co-written with Casey Wilson. The cookbook included many hockey-inspired recipes, including Habs Tourtière, Stanley Cup bars, and Luc Robitaille's lasagna omelette. After retiring from hockey, Williams briefly emerged as a roller hockey player, appearing in one game and scoring 2 points for the RHI's Vancouver Voodoo in 1993. He was also a prominent figure in Canadian punk rock band the Hanson Brothers' campaign to agitate for his induction into the Hockey Hall of Fame in 1996. In recent years, Williams made headlines for his legal issues. In February 2018, he was charged with sexual assault while on a military trip to Latvia. However, the charges were withdrawn by Crown Attorney Megan Cunningham after Williams issued an apology. Despite his legal troubles, Williams remains a prominent figure in hockey history, known for his aggressive style of play and his record-breaking penalty minutes. Here are five iconic Tiger Williams fights as voted by you. Behn Wilson, October 21, 1978.
Behn Wilson and Tiger Williams!
Behn Wilson and Tiger Williams!
Behn Wilson hasn't been able to get a punch in. Tiger Williams is, now he's starting to throw the punches. Tiger Williams is getting some very good punches in on Behn Wilson. Now it's Wilson's turn. Williams got some excellent uppercuts on Behn Wilson. Wilson could not get his right arm free. And Williams took advantage of that to land about six or seven excellent uppercuts to Behn Wilson. Wilson finally got his arm loose and started to punch overhand right to Tiger Williams' side of his head. Now they're pushing and shoving. Wilson is taking another couple uppercuts from Tiger Williams as the linesman Pavelich and Kohalski are trying to separate the two players. They had a hold of...
Jack Mcllhargey, April 22, 1976.
Bring it outside that blue line.
High sticking in front. Mcllhargey with Williams. And they both of them are throwing right hands in reckless abandon. Williams and Mcllhargey. Mcllhargey, of course, not with the benefit of a helmet. Williams still has his helmet on. Mcllhargey still swinging freely, using his jersey as a protection on his fist when he hits the helmet. And it looks as though they're pretty much punched out right now. And very quickly moving in is Claude Béchard and Ron Finn when they sense that they have pretty much punched each other out.
Randy Holt, March 10th, 1979.
Here came out. Now then, Holt goes after Williams. Randy Holt and Tiger Williams.
Boy, they're both tough customers. Holt with 193 penalty minutes. Williams, the league leader, with 266 coming into this game tonight. Burrows, you can see him in the upper frame looking back over his shoulder saying, I'm not in the middle.
Yeah, really no excuse for that, Brian, because it all started out with Burrows taking Murray Wilson out in front of the net. The play was over. Palmateer had frozen on the boards, and all of a sudden, Holt comes steaming out of nowhere. Maybe we'll get a chance to look at how that all started in a moment.
Bob Murdoch, April 11th, 1978.
Boy, it's over. And we have a fight here.
And the Tigers into it with number five, Bob Murdoch. Oh, the Tiger landing some rights. Murdoch trying to come back. Rogge Vachon moves into the attack, and Sittler restrains him. Rogge is furious. He's discarded his goal mask. The referee, Bruce Hood, warning him.
Mel Bridgman, February 22, 1980.
Williams down in the corner. He's wrestling around. And it's Bridgman that he is scrapping with.
Dan, I kind of think Williams and Bridgman have something going. That's the second time tonight, isn't it? You think they'd say, hey, fellas, you know, we're both big, we're both tough, we're both strong, we both have nothing to prove, no one's going to push us around, let's go play hockey. Ooh.
There's Williams with the right hand free. Well, he and Bridgman square up. Oh, his first fight was against Holmgren. And now-
this concludes this episode of Smoke and Ice. Who would you like to see us cover next? Let us know in the comments. Until next time, keep your gloves on the ice. Thanks for watching, good night.